Hit the strip out of school, couldn't wait till I got out of class. Used to stare at the clock and shit. Before all this rap shit, I was gang banging and doing half beats on the cops and shit. And I'm straight from the shop, but I ball like a king up at Cali and shoot like Snowy.
You can keep staring me down.
I'ma take your bitch, watch
you look around.
She is nowhere to be found.
In the bathroom with her, got my dick in her.
What is up? What is poppin'? It's your girl, mother freaking Samara, back in the cut. And today, sis, we're gonna be doing a different... I'm targeting this more towards Boston, but I'm about to tell y'all the different type of riders you will find on public transportation that just makes you want to not go wherever you need to go to. These type of people just make you question why the hell you don't got a car yet. That's basically what this video is going to be. This is going to be a little different type of video, so I hope y'all enjoy this video. Before we get deep into the video, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. Comment down below anything you may want to see in the future. And let's get into the tea. First type of public transportation rider you will find is that stingy as hell person that don't want to give up their seat. Like, I'm not even gonna front. Sometimes when I'm on the bus, I be like hoping nobody's gonna sit next. The best bus rides, train rides, whatever you want to call it, is when you're by yourself, sitting by yourself. It's already enough that you're in a public bus, so I'm not even gonna front. There's times where I don't want people to sit next to me, but if it comes to the point where there's no more seats on the goddamn bus, on the goddamn train, and my legs are aching and burning and they don't want to stand up no more, or the palms of my feet can't take the floor no more, I'm gonna need you to open the seat up. Like, I just really hate those kind of people. Like, I'll see it more if there's a bunch of open seats in the bus, but you're telling me that if the bus is packed and your seat is the last seat and I need it, you're not gonna open it up? You're gonna just leave your bag there? Like, are you kidding me, bro? And it be the old ones too. Most of the time it be the old ones. Like, it be the adults that's stingy. They'll give you that stink look as soon as you hit the bus to let you know, don't sit next to them. Number two, the next type of rider you will find on the public transportation is that nosy one. You don't wanna be next to someone who's over here looking at your phone. Like, that makes me feel so uncomfortable. Like, I'm just scrolling through my phone and whatnot, and I feel something. Like, I feel something on my shoulder. Like, I feel something just looking over me, and I'm just like, are you, like, no, like, no, like, don't, like, oh, like I said again, it's usually the old people. Like, they want to see what you're up to and whatnot. Number three, the next type of bus rider, subway rider, public transportation rider you'll find is the person who comes on the bus with the goddamn speaker. They don't care about who's on the bus, who's listening or whatnot. They come in with that goddamn speaker, like, and they playing, usually they're playing trash music. Like, turn that thing off. Like, no one wants to hear that. And it just gets me more tight when I'm listening to my music in my headphones and I'm too busy being distracted by the board behind me with a freaking, what's it called? Beats pill, whatever they call it, a Beats pill behind me, playing some freaking trash old music. Invest in some headphones and just call it a day. Like, not the whole world want to hear your music. Number four, the next type of public transportation rider you'll find is the one that don't know how to cover their mouth. And when I say that, I mean like the type of person who be coughing and sneezing everywhere and they don't cover their mouth. Ew! Like, it's already enough that you're coughing and sneezing in my environment, but you have the nerve not to cover your mouth. Like, that's nasty. Like, that's really, really nasty. Like, I don't get why people don't cover their mouth. Like, that's really freaking nasty. Like, that's really freaking nasty. And then the fact is, when they do want to cover it, they use their palm of their hands. Do we need to go back to kindergarten? Like, do y'all forget how to sneeze and cough? They use the palm of their hands, and when they touch the freaking poles on the bus, things people use to hold on to, with their nasty old germaphobic, that's not even a word, hands. Like, oh my god, bro, like, and I don't even want to be rude most of the time, because when that be happening and I'm nearby, like, I up and, like, leave, but that's rude. Like, that's rude. But right now, if I have to do that, I will, because Corona's out and ain't nobody trying to catch Corona. Number five, this type of rider you'll find on the public transportation is the loud one. It'd be those loud old kids that just got out of school and don't know how to act, be causing up a chaos in the bus. You have those type of kids. And then you have those people who are on the phone calls and they out here broadcasting. Broadcast. Why can't I say the word broadcasting? Broadcasting. over here broadcasting their whole conversation with the whole world, the whole bus. Like, damn, do you really gotta be that loud? Number six, the next rider you'll find on the bus is the one that hops on the bus with a million of coins to put on the machine. I understand some people gotta struggle, some people don't get their card, and they gotta retort to putting coins on the bus. But let me tell you, if there's a line to get on the bus, and you have coins, you better find yourself to the back of the line, because ain't nobody that'll be waiting for you, especially in the winter, for you to freaking fill up the machine with all your coins, especially the adults, because the adults have to pay way more than teenagers or students. So the adults that have to put like freaking $2, I don't even know, into the machine, and they're using coins, like, just already put yourself in the back. Like, please, like, do everybody the favor, just go to the back. Number seven, the next type of person you will find on the goddamn bus is the crackhead. Like, sometimes crackheads find their way on the public transportation, and when they do, they just make everybody uncomfortable. Like, the crackhead just makes everybody uncomfortable. Number eight, the next type of person you will find on the goddamn public transportation, the one that's staring at you from the distance. So, like I was saying with the whole looking over your shoulder, that's more like if you're next to someone and they're being nosy. But we all have that one time on the freaking public transportation when they're just chilling casually on that bus, subway, whatever it is, and you see someone from the corner all the way further away from you staring at you. Like, no, like, stop staring at, oh my god, that really makes me uncomfortable. Like, I just, like, it just applies, the same rules apply for being nosy. Like, just don't stare. Like, don't people know that's rude? Like, don't people know that's rude? Like, am I the only one that knows that's rude? Because people be doing that a lot. Generally, like, those type of people that be staring at you is just, like, what you looking at? Number nine, the next person you will probably find on the public transportation is the sleeper. You always find that one person who's just knocked out on the bus. Like, they're just knocked out in their own world, like, not giving a, oh, I thought I saw something, thinking about who's around them and whatnot, not even thinking about the stop they're about to get up. They're just knocked. I don't blame anybody that sleeps on the public transportation, because public transportation be taking mad long depending on which one you take. So if you gotta sleep, just sleep. Like, just make sure you don't sleep on me. Number 10, the next type of person you find on the transportation is the people that stink. The people that stink. I can't stand when the bus smells like feet, butt cheeks, armpit. Like, just someone who hasn't took a shower in like a month. Like, I can't stand when the bus smells like that. And most of the time the bus smells like that when it's raining, because of the humidity already and the rain, and just everybody just soggy and nasty. I'll be coming out smelling myself to see if I smell like it, because that's not a smell you want to pick up. Like, that's just nasty. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it's relatable. If it is, tell me in the comments which one was the most relatable one with you. And also comment down below anything else you may want to see in the goddamn future. I'll see y'all in my next video.
I ain't trippin' about no beach, no, I ain't crashin' about no hoes. Man, I rock out with these glizzy like I rock out.